The Regular Beer Project, featuring Old Milwaukee. Beer introduced in 1955 by the Joseph Schlitz Brewing Company as their value price beer to compete with Anheuser-Busch's Busch beer, also introduced in 1955. 24-ounce can, bought this at Racetrack. I think it was $1.59 plus tax. I just looked at the bottom, though, and it said October 11th, 2012, over a year out of date. I don't know how that's going to be, but, of course, I've drank Old Milwaukee many times. I know how that is. Over the years, they've changed their designs. Here's an old 1996 bottle. They used to have the short neck bottles. And a can from 1998 can. This is from a little later when they were doing their OM thing. OM. Trying to change it up. Let's see, there's a lot of glare here. 96, so I've got them mixed up. 96, 98. And this I bought about 4 or 5 years ago in Roanoke, Virginia. Don't see it in bottles too much. They used to sell quart bottles around here in Louisiana, but they stopped. Now we only get the 12-ounce cans and multi-packs and these 24-ounce cans. I don't know if they sell Old Milwaukee Ice anymore. I don't see it on their website anymore. This was 5.9%, did win a silver medal once at the Great American Beer Festival. In fact, Old Milwaukee's won many medals at the Great American Beer Festival. 4.6% alcohol, they won a bronze medal at the 97 festival, silver at 98 and 2010, and gold at 99, 03, and 04 Great American Beer Festival. And their Old Milwaukee Light has won many awards. I don't have that one. Okay. Let's check it out. I don't know. It's not going to be fresh, but in the can, I think the shelf life is pretty long. Okay. They shouldn't have had it on the shelf that long. Thick white head and a clear yellow gold appearance or straw appearance with some bubbles. Still making a decent crackle. Okay, I got some Church's chicken. 4 spices and 1 regular mild because I went over there and they had the special $5.44 after tax. You get the 5 pieces of chicken, the 2 biscuits and 2 sides. Put this extra sharp cheddar cheese down in the mashed potatoes. Already prayed. Okay, down in the mashed potatoes. Put a little bit more black pepper there. Put black pepper on the coleslaw. Wouldn't be right without black pepper, I don't think. And crystal hot sauce. Just soon put that on there. So let's check it out. Okay. Push that cheese way down in there. Way down under those potatoes. Okay. Take a little bite of those potatoes. 1955, Church's, San Antonio, that was Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Church's, 1952, San Antonio, Texas. Unfortunately, Mr. Church died right after. But his family continued and then they sold out. Today it's owned by a holding company. It's all around the world. Let's go with the taste of this. Look how crunchy. licking of the fingers good. A working class fried chicken chain and a working class beer. Nice lacing. Still smells good, like a stereotypical American style lager, sweet, grain. Get your corn and your barley. So it has held up to the age. Sweet, grainy, that beer flavor, you know, it's the flavor most people think of when they think of beer. But it's so mellow, smooth, flavorful, and it has a good bite to it. There's a little bit of hop bitterness, but it's not much. 4.7% alcohol, same as Miller High Life, Miller Genuine Draft. Really pleasant to drink. You can see why it's won so many awards. It has a small following. It's not like it used to be, you know, back in the 80s, when Milwaukee was such a big brand with their Swedish bikini team commercials. And before that, it doesn't get any better than this commercials. But Schlitz ran into a lot of financial problems, and they were bought out by Stroh's. And 82. And then Stroh's was having problems themselves, so they were bought out by Pabst in 99. So this brand, this was on their third ownership. Really their fourth, because Pabst changed hands from the Klamanowitz Charitable Trust. And then in 2010 it was bought out by Metropolis family, the Metropolis family. So anyway, doesn't seem like it's deteriorated at all. It's a little old, but doesn't taste old. It still tastes pretty fresh. So what has this video taught us? A few things. The beer holds up to age in a can. It's got a good price. Might have been $149 plus tax. It's smooth and highly drinkable. And it goes very, very well with Church's fried chicken and mashed potatoes with some added cheese and coleslaw. As part of this project, I would like you to let me know what you think of Old Milwaukee. Have you tried it? Or I would like to see you go try some, preferably in the can, so it would be the same thing we're drinking. And let me know what you think. So thank you for watching this video production.